I'm grateful, grateful, so grateful, just God, to praise you, Lord. heaven and earth and all. What a mighty, what a mighty God we serve. Come on now, if he's a mighty God, why don't you put your hands together and let's celebrate Jesus. And while you're clapping, let's celebrate all the mothers. Hallelujah. Happy Mother's Day. Look at somebody and say, it's Youth Sunday. It's the Youth Sunday. Let's make some noise. Why don't you stand on your feet and help me sing this. If you don't know, we're going to learn it together. It simply says, Hail Jesus, you're my King. Everybody clap your hands. Come on, clap. Hail Jesus, you're my King. Come on. Your life frees me to sing. And I will praise you all my days, because you're perfect in all your ways. Come on, say it again. Hey. Hail Jesus, you're my King. Your life frees me to sing. I will praise you all my days, because you're perfect in all your ways. Let's take it up. Oh, hail Jesus, you're my Lord. Say, I will obey your word. You got it. Because I want to see your kingdom come. Not my will, but yours be done. Say it again. Hail Jesus, you're my Lord. Say, I will obey your word, because I want to see your kingdom come. Hey, not my will, but yours be done. Oh, hail, hail, line of Judah. Say, how powerful you are. Come on, open your mouth. Hail, hail, line of Judah. How powerful you are. Oh, hail Jesus, you're my King. Come on, I hear you. Your life frees me to sing. And we will conquer in your name, and proclaim that Jesus reigns. Hail, hail, line of Judah. Say how powerful you are. Let's work it. Say how powerful you are. Say how powerful you are. Say this with me. Say how wonderful, yeah. Say how wonderful, yeah. How glorious, yeah. Say how powerful you are. Hail, hail, line of Judah. How wonderful you are. Say hail, hail, line of Judah. Hey, say how wonderful you are. Oh, say hail, you're my King. See, your life frees me to sing. And we will conquer in your name. And proclaim that Jesus reigns. And proclaim that Jesus reigns. Come on, can we give God some praise? That's what we come to do today. We come to hail Jesus and to magnify his name.
Happy Mother's Day. I don't know. Is there a sale or something on this side? Cause I don't know. What was y'all just came in and said it's right there. I'm just messing with you. I'm messing with you. Let me read these two cards. The first one says thank you. It says thank you to Pastor Gosnell and church family. Thank you for all the prayers and blessings Thanks for your kindness and thoughtfulness. Hope you know how very much you're appreciated and what a difference you make. Love, Latoya Harris. Amen. The next card says, kindness is many small gestures that together make all the difference in the world. Dear Metropolitan family, we wanted to take this time to express to you how truly grateful we are for all your outpouring of love, help, and support with the passing of John Sr. We don't know how we would have taken care of all the important details without you. We are so blessed to have you in our lives and hope you know how much we appreciate all that you have done for us and continue to do for our church family, the family of John A. Poole Sr. Amen. Amen. Before we pray, I don't take credit for this. This morning, let me read this to you. This is a poem from our very own Bishop Latrell Miller Easterling that she shared with us on yesterday, and they sent it out to us so that we could share with everyone. And it's entitled, If Mother's Day. If Mother's Day is the day you are celebrated for being a birth mother, I join with those who celebrate you. If Mother's Day is the day you are cherished because you chose to open your heart and home to one in need of love, I rejoice with those you welcomed. If Mother's Day is the day you are celebrated for mothering others through the joys and vicissitudes of life, I give thanks for you. If Mother's Day is a day you are imprisoned by the guilt of poor choices, decisions, or actions, may the balm of divine forgiveness wash over you and anoint you with peace. If Mother's Day is the day you relive the trauma of releasing the flesh of your flesh back to God far too soon, I weep with you. If Mother's Day is the day you mourn the loss of your mother in the earthly realm, I pray comfort for you. If Mother's Day is a day you lament because you carried a child in your womb but never your arms, I lift you before our blessed healer. If Mother's Day is the day you resent because you did not feel the tender touch nor soothing embrace of a mother, I receive your truth as you experience your pain. If Mother's Day means nothing to you at all, may you simply be allowed to be. Blessings to all this, to all this Mother's Day. Amen, amen. Again, as we prepare to pray, I pray that we all are there. As a Churchill family, I love them again. They ain't going to two pews. We gonna make do on this one. Don't worry. I pray that we all understand that Mother's Day for some is a joyous occasion, and for others it is not a happy day. So as we tell people Happy Mother's Day today, be mindful of the fact that although it may be happy and good for us, it may not be happy and good for everyone. And if you are still blessed to have your mother, I say today, love on her as much as you can, in spite of everything and anything that is going on in the world. Amen. Amen, amen. Can we pray? Lord, we come this morning as humbly as we know how, just to say thank you. Lord, we thank you because we're just grateful, Lord, that you woke us up this morning. Not only did you wake us up, Lord, but then you allowed us to come into your house this morning. And for that, Lord, we are so grateful. Lord, we pray this morning for every mother who was, every mother who is, and every mother still yet to come. And Lord, we pray, Lord, that you continue to lead each and every one of them. We pray for those who have our mothers, and we pray for those who do not have our mothers. And for those who do not have our mothers, we pray on this day, Lord, that we just take time to remember every memory that our mothers gave us. But right now, Lord, we come to pray about this worship experience. And we pray, Lord, that right now, just for a few minutes, you allow us to forget everything else going on and simply focus on the goodness of the Lord. Lord, we pray right now that we would let go of anything that would cause us not to be focused on your goodness, your grace, and your mercy. And Lord, just come in for a few minutes to have a good time and get filled up in the beginning of another week. Lord, right now we lift the speaker for the morning up, Lord. We ask that you just wrap her in your loving arms and keep her by your power divine. And Lord, as we listen to the speaker this morning, I ask that we listen with open ears. I pray right now that we came in with open hearts, open doors, and open minds. I pray right now, Lord, that even though the enemy might be trying to mess us up and turn us around, that we remember, Lord, you promised to never leave us nor forsake us. You promised that no weapon formed against us would prosper. But more than that, you promised, Lord, to be a light unto our path. So right now on this Youth and Young Adult Sunday, Lord, I pray for every young person under the sound of my voice, whether they are in this building physically or with us in our virtual worship space. I pray for their families. I pray for their homes. But more than that, Lord, I pray this morning that you take them to places they never ever thought that they could go. Lord, allow them to reach a higher heights and deeper depths, and allow us to be right there pushing them as hard and as far as you would allow them to go. Lord, we thank you for each and every one of them. But more than that, God, we thank you for your son this morning. We thank you, Lord, that he gave his life up for us. And right now, Lord, as we prepare to move on in this experience, we pray, Lord, that maybe if it doesn't happen here, somewhere, Lord, this morning, someone will give their life back to the one who gave his life for us. Lord, we lift all this in your precious name this morning. So let all your children say amen, amen, and amen.
Amen. Before we have the children's choir come, can y'all just stand on your feet for just a second? Come on, let's praise God this morning. We're going to let the glory of the Lord rise in this place. Hey! Come on, everybody clap your hands, clap, say. Come on, we come. Let it rise. Come on, let's lift up Jesus' name. Let the glory of the Lord, let it rise. Come on, let the glory, let it rise. Let the praises of the King, let it rise. Rise among us, let it rise. Come on, let it rise in this place. Open your mouth and tell the Lord, yes. Hallelujah. Come on, children's choir. All the young people, come on up. We're going to sing together. Can we give the young people a hand? Y'all too quiet for me this morning. Come on. Look at all the young people. Ain't God good? What a mighty God we serve. Thank you.
move. Come back, come back, come back, come back, come back, come back, come back. Stand right there. Before they move, can you all do me a favor? Can you stand on your feet this morning and thank God for each of you? See, sometimes we don't thank our young people enough. We don't praise our young people enough. We don't uplift our young people enough. And there are a whole lot of other places they could be this morning. They could be home sleep. They could be home sleep. Like, never mind. They could be home sleep. It's Mother's Day. I'm gonna be nice today. They could be home sleeping, resting in their beds. Amen. And instead, they chose to come out and. She chose to come out, but then they chose to come out and participate and sing. So young people, on behalf of the entire church, we thank God for you this morning, and we pray that the Lord continues to bless and keep each and every one of you. Amen. Amen. And let me just say this. I don't like singling out people because somebody gonna say, well, he ain't say nothing to my child. So what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna say, good job, good job, good job. Good job, good job, good job. I get that in a second. Good job, good job. Okay, good job. Let me slide through you two. Let me step down this way for 1 second. Right. There they can sit. Okay. Good job. Right. Good job. And my man, all right. Amen. I say that because, and I do that because I'm coming into year 7, so some of these young people were like, they were babies. They still babies, but they was baby babies. So now to sit here and stand and watch them open their mouths, not only when they're playing and doing what children do, but opening their mouths for the Lord is a blessing. I have been able to extend it. At one time, we were just the best United Methodist Church on Queenstown Road. But I truly believe that if we keep on praying and we keep doing what the Lord wants us to do, and if we learn how to get ourselves out of the way and let people do what the people want to do to bring the young people in, then we can stand out on the corner and say, we have the best Yaya group in the United Methodist Church on Queenstown Road. Now, if you don't know what Yaya is because you're thinking it's a rap person or something, Yaya is nothing but the youth and young adults. Amen. We have had young people come up and sing, and we have young people who come up and stand before the Lord and give a word. And here's the thing, young people, I can't even get some of my older members to get up and say a word, and you all get up here just as nicely. So if nobody else is thankful, you all are making me the happiest pastor of the United Methodist Church on Queenstown Road. Amen. 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 All right, Miss Pat, come on. Come on. Miss Pat, where you? Okay, you good, right? Okay, come on.
Worshiping with us this morning. So could we just wave to them and say, we love you. Happy Mother's Day. There you go. There you go. Look, I got something exciting I want to show you, something that I learned this week that I never, ever knew about. One of my favorite snacks is popcorn. And I found a new kind of popcorn this week. And so I popped some of it. And this popcorn is called Rainbow popcorn. You ever hear that? Nobody? Rainbow popcorn. And if you look at it, you can tell that these kernels are all different colors. Lots of colors. Look at them. There's a purple one. There are yellow ones. There are white ones in there. There are blue ones. But they're all different colors. And so they are called rainbow popcorn. So when you put them in the microwave or you pop them, they're supposed to come out with these special colors. I tried it. Didn't work. I popped Oh, I'm supposed to.
Okay, you're okay. I just need to say something. This isn't just Metropolitan's young people. If you have a young person and you got to carry them up here, then you carry them up here. So I'm going to start with somebody I can talk about. Nat Jr., get the walking. She's a young person. Bring her up here. I'm sorry, parents. I'm not in my 20s and 30s. When I was raised, when my mom and daddy said, get up, we got up. So if you got to bring them up here, you bring them up here. Children don't run parents. Parents are supposed to raise the child. Amen? Amen. Amen. We want every young person in here. Because when we get to heaven, God not going to just have a spot for Metropolitan's young people. Trust me. Yeah, come on. We love all of them. Come on. Come on. There we go. There we go. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, get them all up here. It's okay if you got, yeah, you go. That's it. That's it. Yeah, I'm making some of y'all do work y'all didn't want to do this morning. Yeah. Like, he done messed me all up. Baby crying on me and everything. Now, and I'm on camera. Amen. Amen. Well, we got somebody else. Well, she said, I'm going to be hesitant, but I'm going to come. Okay. Don't worry. It's like, yeah, there we go. Okay, I'm going to help y'all out. If you under the age of, I'm going to be nice. If you in pre-K, elementary, or middle school, I ain't going to take you to high school. Middle school. Come on. There we go. Okay, Miss Pat. There you go. There you go.
Somebody singing happy birthday. But I wanted to show you my rainbow popcorn. You see that? Look, they're all kinds of colors. How many of you have ever seen rainbow popcorn or even heard of it? Rainbow popcorn. But guess what? I thought when I popped this popcorn, it was going to come out rainbow colors. And so I would have blue and red and orange and yellow popcorn. Didn't work. So when I popped it, it all came out this way. Let me show you how it came out. It came out just like this. All white. No colors at all. No colors at all. So I just got a little bamboozled, you know, because I thought, sure, I was going to have rainbow popcorn, not such. But I want to show you also that not only is this popcorn rainbow colored, there are also all kinds of sizes. And so if you look closely, you'll see that we have some that are big, some that are small, and some that are even, they even look a little round, they're a little odd shaped. But rainbow popcorn, all sizes, all colors, don't pop. Colors come out all white all of the time because I made three batches and they all came out white. And I got to thinking, this is Mother's Day. And I got to thinking, you know what? Mothers come in all sizes, all colors, all shapes, all ages. Mothers are in all kinds of shapes and sizes and colors. But just like this rainbow popcorn, mothers have many, 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 many tasks that they do. Did you know that mothers are chefs? They cook your food. Did you know that mothers are cleaners? They wash your clothes. Did you know that mothers are, look, mothers are spies. Did you know that? Mothers are actually spies. They really work for the FBI in disguise. Because they know everything you do. Do you know that mothers also have eyes in the back of the head? Some of them have eyes on the side. Some of them have eyes on the top. But mothers see everything. Everything. Mothers love you. They protect you. They provide for you. Mothers do many, many things. Just like this rainbow popcorn comes in all sizes and all colors. But here's the thing. Here's the thing. Just like this rainbow popcorn always, always turns out to be white when you pop it, mothers always are always on the job. Mothers always are there to protect you, always there to provide for you, always there to cuddle you and to make your tears go away. And yes, they do show up when you don't want them to show up. All you got to do is you just wait till you get to be about 15 or 16 and you think you left your mommy home. Just peep around the corner because mommies are there watching you. Mothers are spies. That's what their job is. They are spies. But Rainbow Popcorn, we can almost say that Rainbow Popcorn is kind of like your mom. All sizes, all colors, do all things, but they are always, always loving you and always around. Isn't that all right? That's all right. That's a good lesson. Now, look, I know today is Mother's Day, and I usually have a little treat for you, but today is Mother's Day. So who should I have a treat for? For the mothers. That's right.
Come on, girl. We ain't doing that.
So here's what I need you to do. Here's your treat. Here's what you're going to do. Today, you're not going to get a treat, but you're going to be the treater. How about that? You're going to be the treater. So I need you to hold out your arms just like this. Hold your arms away like that. There you go. Nice and wide. Now, I want you to go back to your seat, and I want you to find some mother, and I want you to wrap those arms around that mother and say, I love you, mother. Happy Mother's Day. Shall we pray? They don't want to pray either. Okay, bye.
They said, first you talked us up to coming up here. Then you talk about bamboozle. You bamboozled us and ain't give us nothing. We were ready for that gift. Amen. I don't know about any of you, but just looking at the monitor, that was the beautiful picture to see all of these young people and your children up here this morning. That was a beautiful picture. Okay, so at this time, I think we got Michelle Churchill coming for scriptures, I think. Amen. Thank you, young people. Thank you, Miss Pat. Thank you so much. Yeah, Miss Pat, you bamboozled them. You did. Yeah. Especially when you said, guess who gets a treat today? They were like, me, I'm ready. And you said, nah, not you, not today.
Our New Testament lesson is coming from Acts chapter 1, verses 15 through 17, and then moving over to 21 through 26. In those days, Peter stood up among the believers. Together, the crowd numbered about 120 persons and said, "Friends, the scripture had to be fulfilled, which the Holy Spirit through David foretold concerning Judas, who became a guide for those who arrested Jesus. For he was numbered among us and was allotted his share in this ministry. So one of the men who have accompanied us during all the time that the Lord Jesus went in and out among us, beginning from the baptism of John until the day when he was taken up from us, one of these must become a witness with us to his resurrection." So they proposed two. Joseph, called Barsabbas, who was also known as Justus, and Matthias. Then they prayed and said, "Lord, you know everyone's heart. Show us which one of these two you have chosen to take the place in this ministry and apostleship from which Judas turned aside to go to his own place." And they cast lots for them, and the lot fell on Matthias, and he was added to the 11 apostles. Amen. Please stand for the gospel lesson. The gospel lesson is coming from John chapter 17, verses 6 through 19. "I have made your name known to those whom gave me from the world. They were yours, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now they know that everything you have given me is from you. For the words that you gave to me, I have given to them, and they have received them, and know in truth that I came from you, and they have believed that you sent me. I'm asking on their behalf. I'm not asking on the behalf of the world, but on behalf of those whom you gave me because of yours. All mine are yours, and all yours are mine, and I have been glorified in them. And now I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, protect them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one as we are one. While I was with them, I protected them in your name that you have given me. I guarded them, and not one of them was lost except the one destined to be lost, so that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you, and I speak these things in the world so that they may have my joy made complete in themselves. I have given them your word, and the world has hated them because they do not belong to the world, just as I do not belong to the world. I am not asking you to take them out of the world, but I ask you to protect them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world, just as I do not belong to the world. Sanctify them in truth. Your word is truth. As you have sent me into the world, I have sent them into the world. And for their sakes, I sanctify myself, so that they also may be sanctified in truth. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Before we go to our offering, let me just look. We won't do that now? Okay, so Jasmine, I was told you coming forward. Amen, amen, amen.
Hello. Good morning. Good morning, Metropolitan Church family and friends. Can the senior ministry please stand up that are present? Okay. We just want to say happy Mother's Day to everyone. We want you to all know that you are all appreciated. On behalf of the Senior Ministries Committee, we would like to say happy Mother's Day to all the seniors that are 70 plus. Please come and pick a flower that is on the altar after church. Thank you all, and we just want to say happy Mother's Day to everyone. Thank you.
Amen. 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 So, Sherita, as she making her way back to her seat, Sherita, next time I need a month to be filled, I just ask you to take care of that for me, because when I asked, she, you know, Pastor, I can, but she popped up quick today. Megan, that'll be our, yeah, amen, amen, yeah, yeah. So one other thing to do before we go to offering, if there is someone here that we as a congregation have never, ever, ever, ever seen before, don't stand up. Just wave, just raise your hand so we can give you a Metropolitan welcome. Amen, God bless you. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you all. Thank you so much for being here with us. Thank you for being here with us. Now in this place comes the time for us to give back to the Lord in our tithes and offering, in our tithes and offering. As the ushers come forward, as they come forward, LeVar will be holding the basket for our tithes and offering. And this morning, our missional offering is endowment, or the education assistance of endowment. Miss Genevieve and Miss Helen will be holding those plates. If you have your sacrificial offering, you can put it in the tithes and offering. If you have your youth and young adult app rally envelope, you can put it in the middle basket. If you have your taking a trip to wherever you're taking an imaginary trip with us this month, you can drop that in the middle basket as well. Amen? Amen. So if you have your offering ready, simply lift it to the Lord this morning as we pray. Gracious and all-wise God, we come right now, Lord, to thank you for these, your children. Lord, we thank you for their gifts, but more than that, we all thank you for being our giver. So, Lord, right now, we ask that you bless the gift, bless the giver. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Come, let us praise him. Everybody praise him. Come, let us praise him. It's time to praise the Lord. Come, let us praise him. Everybody praise him. Come, let us praise him. It's time to praise the Lord. When the Spirit of the Lord falls on me, I will dance like David danced. When the Spirit of the Lord falls on me, I will dance like David danced. When the Spirit of the Lord falls on me, I will dance like David danced. When the Spirit of the Lord falls on me, I will dance like David danced. Come, let us praise him. Everybody praise him. Come, let us praise him. It's time to praise the Lord. Come, let us praise him. Everybody praise him. Come, let us praise him. It's time to praise the Lord. Praise him, everybody praise him. Come let us praise him. It's time to praise the Lord. Come on and bless the Lord with me. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Hey. Clap your hand if you really love Jesus. 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 Wave 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 your hand if you just said, leap for joy if you really love Jesus. Leap for joy if you really love Jesus. Leap for joy if you really love Jesus. Hallelujah. What's the highest praise? Come on, give them the highest praise. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Amen, amen. Before we go to all things, one thing I should have said was, which thank you, tech team, for taking it off. If you regularly give the Cash App, do not give the Cash App until further notice. We are having a few problems with that. If you use Givelify, type in Metropolitan United Methodist Church and put Severn somewhere in there, because there are a whole lot of Metropolitans in the United Methodist Church. And then you should see a picture of our church. You should see a picture of our church on our Givelify page. So if you wish to give that way, you can. We are beginning to work on other ways to give electronically and prayerfully within the next couple weeks. We will let you know those. But as of now, please do not use Cash App. Do not use Cash App. Amen. Amen. All things.
All things come of thee, O Lord.
And of thine own.
And of thine.
Have we given.
Have we given.
Amen. Amen, amen. You may be seated. You may be seated. Good morning. Good morning. Right now, we are preparing to go into our sermonic selection and then our morning speaker. So before Megan Poole comes forward, we will have a selection by London. London, can you give me your last name? Sheldon was supposed to help me, but he didn't. Creighton, London Creighton, London Creighton. Can we thank God for London Creighton first? And then Megan, to save you time, I'm gonna have you make your way on up. Make your way on up. Come on, Megan. And can we thank the Lord for Megan this morning as well? Amen. Amen.
strength of my life.
Say that because London, how old are you? London, how old are you? I heard you. I'm in my head. I'm thinking of something. So we got this choir on the first Sunday too. Because if you're 16, you older. I don't want you. You know, you come sing anytime you want. Amen, amen. The one thing I'm never, ever, ever, ever going to do is tell a young person that they can't come in here and sing. Because see, what I realize is every day we get older, and if we don't have anybody younger to step in, ain't nobody gonna be left to do anything. Amen, amen. So one more time, just can we thank God for London, and now can we thank God for Megan? Come on, Megan.
Mother's Day to all the beautiful mothers. One day is just not enough. I want to say thank you for all your sacrifices and wisdom. A mother's love is truly unmatched. I'm honored for the opportunity today to speak. Thank you for the pastor allowing me such an amazing opportunity. Thank you for my best friend for believing me so much, suggesting me to the pastor to speak. But most importantly, thank you, God. My title is going to be The Power of Desperate Prayer. Subtitle, Shift Your Mindset. Let me say a quick prayer before giving my message. God, thank you for using me this morning. Let me be your vessel. Fill me up with your spirit so that every word that comes out of my mouth this morning is words you gave me and not my own. Be with me as I know you are. Amen. So I'm definitely going to surprise many people today. God will use anybody for his purpose. Who the flesh may view as unqualified, God will qualify you.
Come on. Come on. Come on. All right.
I will be speaking from 1 Samuel chapter 1. There are so many great lessons in this text. Wish I could speak on them all today, but I will touch on the lessons God put on my heart heavily. I will be focusing on Hannah. What an amazing woman of God Hannah was. I'm going to tell y'all a little bit about myself. I was a teenage mother. I had my first child at 17. And being a mother is not easy by far. But just not having the tools and stepping into that type of role, it was a lot. But to add on to that, God had told me that I was going to break generational curses in my family. And I was like, God, I am not qualified for that. I don't want to change certain things, you know. So I had pushed it off for a long time because I did not want to change. And I knew exactly why I didn't want to step into that position. But this year, a lot happened for me that I was like, I can't continue to live how I'm living and have 3 daughters and 2 sons. I was forced to step in what God called me to do, and that was to break generational curses in my family. Hannah was married to a man named Elkanah, who had 2 wives, one Hannah and the other Peninnah.
Hannah ran into adversity, as we all do. However, what we do when adversity comes is the key. God closed Hannah's womb, meaning she could not have children. Although Hannah was in a situation out of her control, her husband's other wife, Peninnah, would taunt her. Which takes us to 1 Samuel chapter 1, verse 6 and 7. And her rival also provokes her severely to make her miserable because the Lord closed her womb. So it was year by year when she went up to the house of the Lord that she provoked her. Therefore, she wept and did not eat. Has there been a time that you have been provoked about something that was out of your control? Peninnah bullied her for years, which over time took a toll on Hannah. I would think Hannah became depressed and not feeling worthy. I know for sure I have felt unworthy when life has all these expectations and you do not feel you met the mark. However, I can tell you something. We are not on our timing, but God's timing.
Come on.
And I know for me, I did not feel like I met the mark being a teenage mom. And even when I made accomplishments, it wasn't enough. I graduated high school, it wasn't enough. It was just, I just felt unworthy, just alone for having a child so young. So I had to step into my purpose and understand that God knew who I was before he created me. And I had to be who I am and who he called me to be despite of all my insecurities and all my shortcomings. Hannah probably weeped because she's seen her husband's wife had children. Why did you close my womb? We have to understand what God has for us is for us. No one can take what God has for you. Which takes to lesson one. Be patient and trust there's a blessing on the other side of the storm. Hannah did not stoop to Peninnah's level. Hannah wept, and if I had to guess, she probably was wondering, why me? How many times in life have we said, God, why me? We have to shift our mindset to, God, why not me? What do you want me to learn from this situation? I repeat, we must shift our mindsets in the storm. We must ask God, what do you want me to learn from this? I have never heard a testimony that the lesson did not form a blessing. I repeat, I have never heard a testimony that the lesson did not form a blessing. I do not know who this is for, but go into that storm with grace. Go into that storm knowing that there's a blessing on the other side. Knowing that God gave you the tools to come out untouched. Only if you shift your mindset from why me to why not me. God, what do you want me to learn from this? In the midst of the storm, Hannah got desperate. She knew the only way out was God. Therefore, she went to God with a desperate prayer. She was not happy. She was fed up and she was bitter. Which takes us to 1 Samuel chapter 1, verse 10 and 11. And she was in bitterness of soul and prayed to the Lord and wept in anguish. Then she made a vow and said, O Lord of hosts, if you will indeed look on my affliction of your maidservant and remember me, not forget me, your maidservant, but will you give your maidservant a male child and then I will give him back to the Lord for all his days, no razor shall come upon his head. She came to God angry, unhappy, frustrated. She was extremely desperate. When you hear the word desperate, what comes to mind? The definition, desperate, feeling, showing, or evolving a hopeless sense that a situation is so bad as to impossible to deal with. When you are desperate in a situation, you are ready to do anything to change your bad situation. You will risk it all. Hannah understood this situation was not one she could deal with alone. She knew she needed God. She knew the only way to change her circumstance was to get desperate and talk to God. She suffered for years, years. How many people have been suffering in an area of your life you don't see a way out?
Come on.
Well, can I tell you something? If you get desperate enough and go to the Lord and be clear on what you want, with pure intentions, God will answer your prayer.
Yes, he will.
And I emphasize on pure because we go with prayers and our intentions are not pure. Our heart is full of ungodly things when we come, and the reason we want these things are not for the right reasons. But can I tell you, we serve God that works miracles. So I'm going to read 1 Samuel chapter 1, verses 12 through 18. And this really excites me. Every time I read it, I get so excited just to think that God can work miracles on our behalf. And it happened as she continued praying before the Lord. And Eli watched her mouth. Now Hannah spoke in her heart, only her lips moved, but her voice was not heard. Therefore Eli thought she was drunk. So Eli said to her, "How long will you be drunk? Put your wine away from you." But Hannah answered and said, "No, my lord, I am a woman of sorrowful spirit. I have drunk neither wine nor intoxicating drinks, but I have poured my soul out before the Lord. Do not consider your maidservant a wicked woman. For the abundance of my complaint and grief I have spoken until now." And then Eli answered and said, "Go in peace. The Lord, the God of Israel, grant your petition, which you have asked of him." And she said, "Let your maidservant find favor in your sight." So the woman went her way and ate, and her face was no longer sad. Which tells you, no matter how impossible your current situation may feel to overcome, there is a God who can work miracles on your behalf. God did not bless Hannah until she shifted her mindset. Hannah initially wanted a male son because Peninnah was taunting her. When Hannah took her focus off of Peninnah and back onto God, her prayer was answered. But it gets better. God blessed her with more than what she even prayed for initially. She prayed for one male son. God gave her 3 sons and 2 daughters. Hannah had 5 children. The number 5 symbolizes God's grace, goodness, and favor towards humans. And if you don't believe me, we can go to 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 21. "And the Lord visited Hannah so that she conceived and born 3 sons and 2 daughters. Meanwhile, the child Samuel grew up before the Lord." Even when the odds are against you and you feel God does not hear your cry, desperately pray. Do not take your eyes off of him. Be intentional when it comes to praying and worshiping God in the midst of the storm. When situations feel impossible to overcome, think of Hannah. Hannah's anointing is the ability to tolerate and hold under pressure, persecution, never yielding, the posture of faith and the promise of God. So I want to close with a message I heard last week that touched my soul. I mean, tears was flowing, a much needed cry. I heard a lady speak named Nona Jones on rejection and the gift of rejection. She spoke on a man named David in the Bible, which goes back to Samuel is the prophet that anointed David, whom may be known as King David. However, the story leading up to him being anointed, which goes back to shifting your mindset, I will make this short. The Lord sent prophet Samuel's Hannah's son to a man named Jesse, asked him to bring his sons because one would be anointed as king. Jesse brought 7 of his sons. Samuel went through them all and said, none of these.
Come on.
"Are these all your sons?" Jesse responded, "The youngest is back attending to sheep." Samuel told Jesse, "Bring him."
Bring him to me.
When Jesse's youngest son arrived, let's read 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 11 and 13. And Samuel said, "Jesse, send and bring him, for we will not sit down till he comes here." So he sent and brought him in. Now he was ruddy with bright eyes and good looking. And the Lord said, "Arise, anoint him, for this is the one." Then Samuel took a horn of oil, anointed him in the midst of his brothers. The Lord's spirit came upon David from that day forward. So Samuel rose and went to Ramah. Samuel was a left attendant to sheep. That rejection prepared him for what was to come.
Yeah.
While attending sheep, he had to fight off lions and bears. When he was out there, there was no one but him and God. David was in the field getting prepared for Goliath. I'm sure if y'all know that story, that's where he's mostly known about. No matter who left him out in that field, it is not your detriment, but to your good. Does not matter who overlooks you, did not invite you, because if God is for you, who could be against you? All my rejections was training grounds for the character and the skills that God needed to build to walk in the purpose that God had for me. And she left me with 4 points that really resonated with me. The gift of rejection positions you for purpose. The gift of rejection reveals people's roles in your destiny. The gift of rejection anchors your identity, being exactly who God called you to be. What God has for me has my name on it. Most importantly, lesson, the gift of rejection draws you closer to God. And I'm here to tell you that rejection has made me stand in my purpose. Rejection has made me to show up for my children, to show them that we can be anything despite the story that God had initially gave us. Despite how we showed up, we don't have to end that way. So when I stand here today, I stand here for all 5 of my children to let them know that we can be fearless, we can do anything we put our minds to. And I just wanna say one extra thing. My mother, if you know my mother, she is very much easygoing. When I told her about this task, this lady texts me every day, every night, have you read, have you prepared, come practice, come, like, this lady was on top of me. She shared my posts over and over and over and over. So I appreciate all my family, my friends, everybody that showed up for me, because this is just the beginning to something great. Amen.
So can everybody that's here for Megan, who came today, can you stand, please, so we can recognize you? Amen, amen, amen. So before we open the doors of the church, let me just say this. I had to calm myself down when I walked up. Because, you know, everything that the Lord tells you sometimes, you hear it, you go, nah, Jesus, I'm not doing that. And we've been having young people speak now for almost a whole year. And I'm going to be honest, it blows my mind. Because see, the job of a pastor is not only to shepherd the people, but then to give an opportunity for people who may not ever be able to have a voice to get up and have a voice. I never want to be the pastor who's the only one that can stand behind this desk. Because when it comes to God's word, God has a man and a woman and a child that can bring it forth. So when I...
It's all right.
And see, Megan, you said that you ain't feel like you were worthy. Me neither.
Me neither.
Every time I get up, I have a little talk with the Lord asking, why me? But then I understand that God always uses the people that nobody else thought could be used. So trust and believe, young people, I am the happiest pastor ever, not just today. And some of my not young people will get upset. But young people, when some of the not so young people get on my nerves, I think of all the joy that you all bring me. And that's what helps me keep going in ministry.
Yeah.
Because people can push your button. But children love you in spite of everything and anything. So thank you all for just not being afraid to say yes. And I guess now, Megan, you didn't got yourself put on the schedule because you stood up here and said, this is just the start. So amen. Amen. I also say this to say that I don't push anybody because I believe that God does the pushing and all we do is open the door. But we have this thing called lay servants, and some of you don't realize that I believe that's where y'all are heading. And I think you're going to go further as long as somebody keeps giving you the opportunity. So I am so thankful. I know it's about mothers today, but for me today, it's just about seeing that the Lord keeps on blessing me, even when I don't know if what I'm doing is right. I guess that's why they used to say, you can't make me doubt him, because I know too much about him. So every time you tell me it's a no, I know that's God saying it's a yes and go ahead. So before we go, we have got to allow and open these doors, because just because everybody's in church doesn't mean they have a church home, doesn't mean they know the Lord for themselves. We may have strayed and we find ourselves on the side of the road, but we serve a God who continues to stand right there and simply says, come on back, come on back. So this morning, if you don't know this God that we talk about, this God we sing about, this God we pray to and pray about, this God we even cry about, then the doors of the church are open this morning. The doors of the church are open. If there's one this morning, won't you come? Won't you come? Who are 70 to come up here bum rushing. If you are 70 or older, can you raise your hand? We're not gonna make you move if you're 70. Okay. So this is what I'm gonna do, because it's Mother's Day, so I'm not gonna ask you women to move. I'm gonna ask Nat Jr. if you can get away, go in my office, look right down at the floor, you're gonna see a bucket with flowers. Bring that. I'm gonna ask Ron, since he's right there. And let me see, who else can I bug? Come on, Adrian, good. Adrian's raising his hand. Y'all come on up here and help me out. Y'all help me out, please. But I'm gonna need somebody else, some more people, because I wanna do this quick and I don't wanna help. Come on. Yep, come on, thank you. Come on, LeVar, are you good? Come on, you standing up. So I figured since you stood, that means you was volunteering. I don't know. So we gonna take these. If you're 70 and older, from what I just heard, you're going to get one of these flowers. Now, please, seasoned people, don't let somebody come give you a yellow and say, can I have a red instead? Can you just take whatever we're about to give you, please? God bless you.
Okay,
if you're 70, raise your hand high. We need to I want you to know. 70 and up, raise your hand high so we can get you. We got enough, y'all. Don't get upset. Don't get upset. We gonna get you. Trust me.
Time I broke your heart.
70 and up, and you don't have one. Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Okay. So wait a minute. Hold on. Everybody that's in here, I need y'all to hear the key word that's in here. If you're 70 and up, do you have a flower? We have some. Come on, y'all stop now. We got them. Don't y'all get upset over flowers now. Adrian, take that to Miss Genevieve.
Give me my flower.
Anybody on this side don't have one?
While I live.
Okay, now. I'm going to say senior ministries, thank you. Because now I know I got enough. Now, if you 70 and you just got a flower, don't you look yet to get one of these roses, okay? So now what I need is, I need everybody that is a mother. And I'm gonna define this. I don't care if you have biological children, that makes you a mother. But if you taking care of some children and helping raise children, even if they not your children, as far as I'm concerned, you a mother. So can you raise your hand and we're gonna give you a rose.
Give me my flowers, give me while I live. Oh, ain't no good when I'm gone. While I live, oh, ain't no good when I'm gone. When I'm gone, we'll take my body.
Your mother, raise your hand. You all start passing those roses. Pass those roses. It might be enough. Let's see.
Content.
The trustee said, you ain't gonna make me mess up your head like that, Pastor. What's wrong with you? Okay, raise your hand. I think we might have enough. Boy, I've never seen people, y'all are getting vicious about these flowers. Okay, I mean, they like, get back here, give me a flower now.
One by one, count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings.
Does every woman have a flower? Flowers up. Ron, don't you give all them flowers out yet like that. Stop trying to be Casanova. I got to watch you over. I love messing with these kids.
All right.
Does every woman now have a flower? And the reason I said that, you all, see, is I have to cover my own bases. I need two. I need more than that. How many you have? Okay, good. So, flowers. Because, you know, you are a thing. You give my flowers. I got to give a flower to my own wife. Then I got to give a flower for my mother. Then I got to give a flower for my mother-in-law. Getting in trouble, y'all. That's why I was like, hold on, y'all. Give me a flower, y'all. Got to wait. I gotta make sure I get my bases covered. Let me see. Michael Sims and Wendy. And Aaron. Do you have a flower for Miss Wendy? Then get that flower for Miss Wendy. Oh, she is. So she wants the other flower. Hold on. Give me my rose back, man. Adrian, take one of those potted ones back to Michael and Aaron, please. You know, Adrian, you could have just walked around this way. It'd have been okay. Yeah. All right. Let me see. Okay. A flower. Thank you. Come on. Bring me another one. Take that one right there. Thank you. Anybody else? Okay. In the back. And then take one. Get two, Adrian. Well, Ron has one, but Ron wanted another. Adrian, you know you can just come around here, right?
I take a look around.
Okay. Let me find out. I hope that I don't press a button here. Hey, Ron, give that to Michelle Churchill. Give that to Michelle Churchill in honor of your mother. Amen. Let me see. Is there anybody else I forgot? Because I don't want to leave anybody out. I don't leave nobody out. Let me see. Okay, I think we're good. Okay, good. So now that I can pull one out for my sister-in-laws too. See, I'm trying to really make sure I'm in the family good today. Yeah. They mothers, ain't they? Well, I don't have nothing to do with that. That's between your mother and father, not me. I don't have anything to do with that. Somebody call me. One of what? Oh, look at you. You really trying to hook me up, Sharita? Yes, let me get this balloon that I bought. Yeah. Look at Sharita giving the pastor brand new presents. Yeah, I told her to get this. Yeah, okay, you're right, I did. And you get a balloon as well. Amen. Take that to Megan. Nat, thank you so much. Now, let me see. Brothers, do y'all need any flowers for anybody? Because I know we mess up sometimes. Nat, you need some flowers to get. Okay. Let me see. Now, everybody that's a mother has a flower, right? What you need, Megan? Okay, so I know there are some mothers who are not here. So Caitlin and Jenny, give this to your mom. I'm doing the best I can, y'all. When they run out, you can't get mad. I'm looking. I'm scanning the area. Who else? Thank you. There we go. Thank y'all for helping. Now, who can I give these to? Who can I give these to so they get them? All right. Okay, Nat. Run that down back to Curl. Miss Curl, my head. This one, okay, Ron got one. Okay. Hold on. Hold your thought. You let me talk to you first. You take that to Gail Bell. Yeah, thank you. Okay. Now I got you, Miss Gertrude. Yes, I need a rose. Miss Helen, give this to LaToya. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Miss Helen. Yes, let me look.
Every time I turn around, the Lord keeps losing me.
I need two more, please. Now you good. Okay, I know that somebody can help me on this. I know Jessica Snipes should get one. Is Jessica seven? She is? Okay, so we give her a potted plant. Yep, just put it on the side. She can pick it up. Jessica, if you're listening, you come to church and get your potted plant. Thank you. Okay, thank you. I pray that we got everybody. And it looks like we got almost everything passed out. So again, you all, thank you. Oh, wait a minute, hand me one. Miss Jeanette, give that to your daughter. Watch the rules, I mean the death, thorns. Okay, I think we're good. I pray we are. So if all minds are satisfied, can we stand all over the building, please? Brothers, thank you. Mothers, ladies, thank you. Young people, thank you. Tech team, thank you. Ushers, thank you. Musicians, thank you. Megan, thank you. And I think we thanked everybody. So can we look to the Lord to be dismissed? Gracious and all, God, we thank you this morning for allowing us to be in your presence. Now, Lord, as we prepare to leave this place, we ask that you go before us, make our path safe, easy, and successful. And Lord, if it be your will, allow us to continue to be a blessing to everyone who comes our way. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Mother's Day.
Lady,
happy Mother's Day. Hey, Ron
God,
Rose.
God's gonna turn around. It's gonna work in your favor. Hey, lady. Late in the midnight hour. God's gonna turn around. And around. And around. And around. And around. Late in the midnight hour. God's gonna turn.
One second.